it's everything. Happiness over everything, over anything, and it's everything to me. Hey y'all, it's your girl YsaTheEsthie back at it with another Big Show Friday. Okay, so this week's topic is still acne related, and it just has to do with some more internal aspects. So today I'm gonna mainly be talking about like gut health and some vitamins that I'm taking to kind of like prevent my acne, prevent new pimples from growing, things like that. Just really give myself like this sort of effect, just that like inside out. So I definitely want to go ahead and put some good stuff into my body, because you already know gut health is super important. Like, what we put in our body literally determines how everything else works, all of our body systems. And definitely what we put in really determines that energy we get out. And even just not for gut health, like in any type of aspect in our life, like the energy that we put in to whatever it is, a project, a new whatever, like the energy we put into that, if we give it 110%, we're really all in, that energy we get out is going to be phenomenal. So let's go ahead and get right into it. I want to go ahead and talk about these tiny but mighty vitamins I've started taking and the benefits that they offer. Let's get it. All right, so this first one I take is called Vitex Berry. So first of all, I just want to go ahead and let y'all know that I get mainly most of my vitamins from like Whole Foods. Basically, that's usually where I get them from. I don't want that to intimidate some of y'all. I know some of y'all maybe have never even stepped foot inside of a Whole Foods. No biggie. I'm always going to link stuff below. Most likely it's like Amazon, or if I find any other cool websites, I will link y'all to them. But definitely just do your research. Just see what's out there. See what you can afford. See what you would like to try. But research, research for research. I don't want to like say Whole Foods and y'all be like, okay, bougie, thesis. But, you know, I just kind of trust Whole Foods. I know that they have like a higher standard to their products. Everything is usually like certified organic. Some might be vegan. So I just know they go a little deeper into that vetting process to finding their, what's the word? To finding their products and their, why can't I think of it? I guess vendors, I'm going to say. I'm just going to say vendors. So, you know, just produce the best type of product that they can afford. So I just like that aspect of Whole Foods. It is a health food store. So health foods, like that's exactly what I'm going there for. So just do your research. Like, I want you guys to be comfortable, like thinking about going into places like that. Like, Whole Foods is for everyone. Like, I know the demographic they kind of target. It always seems a little, you know, bougie, high end. It doesn't really seem accessible to everybody, but I definitely want you to know that it is accessible. Feel comfortable in those places. Like, if you're looking to get into, like, you know, just being a healthier person, you want to start taking certain vitamins you might not be able to find at like Walmart, Target, not like the usual vitamins, I guess. Vitex Berry, I never heard of that before until like I was doing my research, and they only really have it at like health food stores like Whole Foods. So like, I really had to go into there and actually find it there, because no one else really had it except online. But I just say all that to say, like, I really want you guys to get comfortable in stores like that. Like, you belong there. You deserve to be there. Your health matters too. So definitely get comfortable. Even if you just go in there and walk around, see what they have to offer, and leave. You don't buy anything. It doesn't matter. Just get comfortable being in places like that. Like, if you're looking to start that health journey and really just create that my body is a temple vibe and really like get on your healthy ish, go there, see what they have to offer you. You're not limited to just your local stores, your local Walmart, Target, Publix. Like, you have options. Please explore them. So I just want to throw that out there, but let's go ahead and get into Vitex Berry. So like, I was just, you know, doing my research, doing a deep dive on Google. I was really just trying to like find like vitamins, supplements, things that I can intake internally and really get like, you know, my gut health right and just start working on like my body systems inside out, because obviously our skin is a reflection of what's going on the inside. So if we're seeing a lot of breakouts, a lot of stress pimples, a lot of just, you know, favorable activity on our skin, it's usually because something's going on inside. So I definitely was like, you know, understanding that I'm getting breakouts in the same places and they're reoccurring. They're very inflamed. Some are like deep underneath the skin. I'm getting a lot in my chin, around the mouth, this lower cheek area that definitely just deals with a lot of hormonal aspects to our body. So I can really just associate all this breakout that I was dealing with hormonal acne. So I was just looking for ways to improve on hormonal acne, things I could eat or drink or put internally to go ahead and get a different reaction out of my skin. Because everything I'm putting topically is working, but I definitely feel something internal needs to come out, needs to purge per se. So I was just definitely trying to find, you know, ways that I could do that. So with Vitex, what I found, it is our herbal supplement, and it's more focused on balancing hormones and helping maintain women's reproductive systems. So it definitely helps with like PMS, PCOS, infertility, menopause. I don't know why the sprinkler is going off, but things like that. So it definitely helps women get a handle on things in that nature and just, you know, soothe those inflamed body systems and get it to working in proper condition. So it's also antibacterial, antifungal, and anti-inflammatory. So obviously that's just going to help with that acne causing bacteria we have on our skin. Sometimes we have too much and it gets trapped with the sebum in our pores and boom, pimple. So it definitely just helps maintain all that. So also an awesome benefit to this herbal supplement. I would strongly suggest if you are gonna start taking Vitex Berry, please consider switching up your diet. If you're gonna stay on your processed food diet, you're gonna stay with dairy, alcohol, caffeine, sugar, like gluten, things like that, you're really not gonna see a big change. You'll see a little bit because I've seen some change since I've started it. But honestly, I need to take it that next step up and really like clean my diet up and go back to being plant-based. And I know I'm gonna see this vitamin like take off. So I definitely want you guys to consider that. Like, it's just really not gonna work as properly as it could if your body's also fighting the inflamed foods that you're putting into it and trying to like, you know, I say melt because, you know, our stomach acids, but, you know, dissolve this like herbal supplement into our blood system and really get it going. Your body's gonna have a hard time doing that when it's still fighting all those inflamed foods that we're eating. So definitely consider just cleaning up your diet if you are gonna start this vitamin. And I do want to say, everything about this acne journey is not a one-stop shop. This is not a quick fix. This is not a band-aid. We are healing this wound. So it's gonna take some time. So I definitely suggest keep at this consistently. Like, if you're gonna take this every day consistently for about 3 months to start seeing some solid progress. You're definitely gonna have to take this for like 6 to 9 months, 6 to a year. Like, you really wanna stay long term with this so that you can experience all of the benefits that this herbal supplement has to offer. But definitely stay strong for at least that first 3 months, those first 90 days. It takes 21 days to form a habit. It takes 90 days to make it permanent. That 90 days is that 3 months. So definitely like, you know, just push yourself to stay consistent. You'll thank yourself later. So definitely, I've been on it a little over a month now, and I do see, you know, some of those changes when I do take my vitamins. Like, my skin does seem a little clearer in certain aspects. The breakouts aren't as bad. So I know internally plus topically, like, everything is working. It's very copacetic. But yeah, I definitely need to go ahead and take that step up, clean my diet up super, super clean so that I can really experience all the benefits that this vitamin does offer. So next up is vitamin E. We all know vitamin E is an awesome antioxidant, which just means it's effective at fighting the effects of free radicals that are produced by the toxins in the environment. They're just damaging to our skin, so this just helps protect it from that. It's also anti-inflammatory, so it will help boost your immune system by cell regeneration. That just means It's really just going in, providing all those awesome nutrients to our cells so that they can go ahead and create more cells and divide properly so that we're producing better and new skin cells every time. After that is vitamin A. So we talked about last video retinoids, which are a derivative of vitamin A. So I'm also internally taking vitamin A so that my body systems on the inside can do what they gotta do. My topicals can do what they gotta do and get all of this gunk out of my skin. So I just wanted to reiterate that a retinoid is a derivative of vitamin A and is mainly used for anti-aging capabilities. I know acne isn't obviously a directly anti-aging like thing, but it does just help with that cell regeneration we just talked about, and it speeds up that process a little bit faster. So it just helps those skin cells rise to the surface a lot quicker. It turns over our dead skin cells, blah, 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 boom. Our dead skin cells are falling off a lot faster and revealing that new fresh skin from underneath. So it just helps to kind of speed that up. Remember, like I said, our cells regenerate once every 28 days. So this just definitely tries to speed that process up a little bit faster. So we are seeing bright, new, clear skin from underneath. So other than that, it helps to normalize our oil production, and it just promotes healthy collagen and elastin formation in our skin. That just gives us that plump skin effect versus, you know, more mature skin. It doesn't have that, it kind of sags a little more, it doesn't have that bounce factor. That's what collagen and elastin really do. So other than that, it also helps with pigmentation and just provides moisture to your skin. So it does give you that healthy glow from within. So definitely look out for taking vitamin A. This is also another option if you are still a little nervous about starting a retinol or a retinoid and you don't really know where to go from there. Internally taking it will still give you the same effects, just more internally. So you don't really see it as quickly, but it will help. So last but not least, the last vitamin I take specifically for my acne is called zinc picolinate. Zinc in general is vital for cell growth, collagen formation, that plumpness, and for wound healing. So our acne scarring, our inflamed acne in general just helps to soothe and calm the skin down. A lot of products do have zinc, like sunscreen has zinc oxide, which is a very calming product for the skin. So look out for zinc. Like, zinc is super good for the skin. The part of this zinc pill that I take, the picolinate, that's just a form of zinc. It's just a very soluble form of zinc that we internally can take and our body will process and digest very easily. So that little aspect is just how soluble it is. So this is mainly just like a zinc vitamin. Zinc is also a very important mineral because we cannot form it in our body, but we need it. So we need it. So because if we are zinc deficient, that can lead to hair loss, rough and dry skin, acne, and just a slow healing process to our old scars and wounds. So zinc is awesome for the skin because it just really helps. It gives us that boost that we need, and we can't actually form it, so we have to get it from external sources. So please make sure you're getting that from your foods, from the vitamins and minerals that you are taking, other supplements as well, not just these. Please, please, please look out for zinc. Super important. So those are mainly the vitamins that I'm taking. I take more vitamins, but obviously different health reasons, just more internal health, general health, women's health. Like, I take different vitamins, different reasons. But those are the four that I specifically take for acne. Like, if I don't take the rest of my vitamins, I make sure I take these at least, because I really, really, really want to see that progress in my skin. And I know it starts with me being consistent. So take your vitamins, kids. I do want to go over some like just quick do's and don'ts with like a diet. I mean, I'm not like a certified nutritionist. So, you know, I'm definitely not trying to give you guys too much. Definitely do your research. I do my research. I see what works for me. I try it out. I go with it. So for diet, some do's, just definitely get in those leafy greens. Like, if you're not really ready to you know, just do a 360 change and just go like, okay, yeah, I eat fried foods this, that, and the third. Oh, I'm vegan tomorrow. Like, you don't have to go extreme like that, but definitely just start implementing. Hey, bird. You just start implementing and adding in versus trying to take away, because that mindset will also help you. Because when you're adding in, it's like, okay, well, I just need to give myself more of this and more of that, more veggies, more fruits, rather than, oh, I need to cut out this, oh, I need to cut out this, oh, I need to cut out this. Because that just kind of gives you that limited belief, you know what I mean? That limited feeling like, okay, well, I can't eat this. Rather than you should just be like, well, I can eat this. I could add this. I could put this in there and I can add that. So just, you know, the verbiage that you're using with yourself definitely is important. Because if you keep like, I can't do this, I can't do that, I can't do that, like, it's just going to stress you out, because you just feel like, okay, well, I can't eat this, I can't eat this, and I can't eat this. What can I eat? I can eat air, water, ice. Like, so I definitely just want you guys to slowly add these things in, and then you can start to kind of subtract and take away what you don't really need to that diet. So we're definitely adding our cruciferous greens. That's like broccoli, kale, spinach. Dark leafy greens, that'll give you vitamin A, vitamin E, that'll give you all that from your food. So definitely add those in. Some healthy fats, avocado and salmon. Love me some salmon, boy. Specifically mentioned was apples. They just have an antioxidant that's really good for your skin as well. They had mentioned blueberries, but I'm going to tell y'all to take it a step up and go and look for wild blueberries. There's a difference when you are at the store. I know Walmart has them. I believe Publix has them. All your local health foods will definitely have them. They're mainly like organic, so you'll see them there. Wild blueberries are just, I'm going to say, they're grown a little bit differently than normal blueberries, but they have like basically double everything a normal blueberry has. They have like double the antioxidants, double all the benefits. So definitely just look out for wild blueberries. They're really good. They taste the same, but they just have a little bit more benefits to them just of how they're grown. So other than that, I would say also ground flax seeds. You can definitely like incorporate this in like your oatmeals, your smoothies, things like that. It's a superfood, basically. Like, it's really rich in antioxidants, your fibers, and your healthy fats. Like, boom, 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 hits all three. And I just want to, like, specify ground flax seeds, because whole flax seeds, our body cannot digest them. So we will poop them out and they will still be seeds. So make sure you grind them up just so you can get all the benefits inside the actual flax seed. Some don'ts for a diet. Y'all got acne? Y'all need to stop eating red meat. I'm gonna tell you this right now. Cause it takes our body forever to digest meat. And just that red meat and the gases and all that stuff our stomach produces as it's trying to break down that meat is just low-key toxic for the rest of our body. And that meat will sit in our stomach and it takes us forever to digest it, guys. Please, please, please consider just lessening your meat. Trust me, I'm Haitian and Honduran. I'll be wanting some carne asada. I'll be wanting some guillo. Like, fam, I know. It hits me from both sides. People are like, when I went plant-based, people are like, you don't eat meat? Why? What do you mean? You're Haitian. That doesn't work. I know. But hey, my skin is looking more important. I mean, I'd rather not be having to deal with super inflamed breakouts all the time. If cutting a little bit of meat out of my diet is what makes my skin smooth, I personally am willing to do it. That's up to you if y'all are willing to do it, but definitely just try to lessen that. Like, if that's an option, try to choose a lighter option. Let's see if we can get some salmon in our diet. Let's see if we can just keep it to the white meat, keep it to chicken and turkey, and slowly start to cut back. Just slowly cut back. Everything is in moderation, because we want this to actually stick. I don't want you guys to cut all this stuff out of your diet and then sit up there and like, okay, I'm hungry, what do I eat now? Or have a really bad cheat day and then you're like, oh my god, I fell back, like, ugh, I did the wrong thing, I binged, like, I had so much meat, I feel sick now, like, oh. So I don't want you guys to get to that extreme. definitely just take those baby steps to really establish like a solid foundation in your life when it comes to eating plant-based and just adding more plant-based meals to your diet and just getting in that good gut health. So guys, please don't like rush this process. Take your time with it. Really like, really immerse yourself in this experience and just try to just change yourself. So definitely slow down on the red meat. Foods that are rich in saturated and hydrogenated fats, like our baked goods, our fried foods, anything slathered in margarine or butter, things like that. Like, I feel like y'all have a picture that comes in y'all heads when I say this. Like, you know what foods I'm talking about. The bad ones. So slowly cut those back. Try to just make healthier choices, more conscious, intentional choices. You could be at the drive-thru like, okay, am I going to get a number 5 and supersize it? Or should I actually just kind of get a salad? Should I try to see if they have a lettuce wrap instead of eating bread? It's always a good option to ask and see. Some places really might have it and you don't even know. But, you know, just ask around. Definitely try to make those small changes. Other than that, if you are considering going plant-based, vegetarian, vegan, whichever, please, please, please be careful of soy. Soy is very high in estrogen, which will throw off our levels and also create acne in our skin. So please be careful when you are trying to transition to vegetarian, vegan, and you're buying those meat subs, you're buying subs as in meat substitutes, sorry, and you're, you know, just getting those additional substitutes that you can put into your meals that kind of give you a meat aspect, things like that. Please just read those ingredients, because definitely there's a lot of soy in those products unless it states soy free. And just eating too much soy will raise our estrogen levels, which will throw off our bacteria for our acne and just create more inflamed acne. So please, please, please keep that in mind. If you are trying to do a plant-based diet like that, just add in more of your greens, your vegetables, your fruits, your good starches, like sweet potatoes and all that. Add more of that in first before you start taking stuff out, just so your body can get used to it and then start to cut back on all those not so good things. So definitely keep out for soy and soy products. Dairy boys. I'm gonna say this one time and one time only. We are not baby cows. That's it. We don't need cow milk. We are not baby cows. Those nutrients and those hormones are not meant for our bodies. That is meant for a baby cow. That's not us. Please, please, please consider plant-based options. Almond milk, my fave. Oat milk, cashew milk, coconut milk. Any kind of milk, bro. There's milk from anything. Anything, anything. Please, please, please find one that you like. There are so many options out there. There's so many flavors. My specific almond milk I like is unsweetened vanilla. Like, I have a very specific one that I drink, but I love it. And I'm willing to make that change. Like, I do not drink cow milk with, like, my cereal, my coffee, none of that. I still eat ice cream. But that's a different story. I'm looking to try to cut that back, too, because I definitely want to see some progress in my skin. And if that's what it takes, I'm on it. Also, cut back on that gluten. So bread, cookies, cake, wheat, pasta. Like, when y'all think about it, pasta is such a bad meal for acne. Like, say a chicken Alfredo. Because one, you got the pasta with gluten that might be affecting your body system. Two, you got the sauce that has dairy and cheese and cream and all those dairy products. Your skin's gonna hate you. But please, like, be mindful when you are choosing foods like that. I'm not saying don't eat them all the time, because I definitely bust down on some macaroni mermaid the other day and it was fire. So, you know, just eat it in moderation. Like, if you are going to eat it one day, make sure you are balancing that out with your greens and your fruits and your veggies. So, all in moderation, y'all boys. And I do want to stress that I'm not a doctor. Like, I am not a certified medical doctor. So if you do have any like health or skin questions that go farther than the epidermis, farther than that first layer of skin, please, please, please get in contact with a nutritionist, a dermatologist, or your just regular general practitioner, because I know they can take a deeper dive into your body systems and do some tests and really, you know, see the problems, see where they lie. Like, they can officially tell you whether it's hormones or it's something else or whatever the case may be, like they can give you that exact pinpoint. So definitely reach out to them. Don't be afraid of going to a doctor or a medical professional for help in that aspect, because that's what they're there for. They can really help you out. So I definitely just want to go ahead and always throw that out there, because it's important to keep up with your body. I know we definitely try to self-diagnose and really just like, okay, I think this is it, but always just double check with the doctor. They're the professionals in that aspect. But you know, I just like going at this stuff from more of a holistic perspective. Like, I just more so don't want to, like, you know, incorporate like any kind of drugs or prescribed pills or things like that unless I need to, unless a doctor has told me like, yes, this is the route we should take for optimal health. Okay. But other than that, like, I know it's usually something I'm eating, something I'm drinking, something I'm not drinking or intaking or putting into my body. So I just like to figure it out that way. Please, please, please listen to your body, y'all. Your body talks to you like crazy. We just don't pay attention. That stomach ache we feel after we've eaten that burrito, we probably shouldn't eat either that much, or we shouldn't have a meal that heavy, or something, you know, something just didn't agree with us. Like, listen to your body. Like, your body's talking to you in certain ways. And if you don't actually understand what your body is saying to you personally, there might be a problem. There'll be a disconnect. So definitely just, you know, listen to yourself. Consider all the options that you have, because there are so many out there. Please, please, please do your research. If you like this video, like, comment, subscribe. Let me know what's up. Let me know if you want anything for me to talk about, anything else. Just comment below, new topics. I love to talk about this kind of stuff with y'all. I'm excited to share more deets coming soon. But other than that, that's all I want to talk about. You know, keep cultivating what is good. I know this journey is going to be long, but it's going to be worth it. Okay, y'all? So I love y'all. Peace out.